Abyss called this Darth helmet or Darth Vader helmet earlier. Or was that you, enemy?
No, that was Abyss.
Oh. On delivery. Does happen sometimes. Did you figure out what happened with the bake?
Pardon me?
Did you figure out what was going on with the bake there at the bottom part you said? There was some issues?
Yeah, there was the cage. Cage was issues.
Okay, so we're super early in the subdivision, but it's smooth enough where you can move forward. And refine it with way more polygons. So I actually might still divide twice and then start doing the mask, so we can do the extrusion of a little bit, very very thin extrusion of the framework of the helmet. Actually, hold on a second, this part needs a little bit of work. This bend here, I don't like it. Closer. Oh, that's gonna be pretty tough, actually. Should have been another sub too. Shut up. You're about to talk about subgroups, weren't you?
You can still make it a polygroup if you go down to the bottom.
True. But guess what?
Not gonna happen.
No. Not tonight, sir. What the hell's with this song? Yeesh. Music a little low? Just me. It's a little low, isn't it?
I don't have the stream going on.
Alright, I'm gonna turn it up a little bit. Oh hey, what's up, Foxygen? How's your super late night live workshop going? Sorak, I think that was the name. Thank you for the solo. That was a combination of sub and follow. He goes and stream games, right? We have in the past. But we've been super busy that we haven't been able to do sub games, you know, some sub Dota games and hopefully other games in the future. But we'll get back to that when we're not crunching for TI5. And show your amazing 3K MMR in Dota. Though if we play Team Fortress 2, we'll be owning the whole server. I can actually say I'm really, really good at TF2. But yeah, Dota, 3K, which is not bad, but obviously not amazing.
Used to play a lot of TF, right?
What's that?
Used to play a lot of TF?
Tons of Team Fortress. We played in the leagues, man. We went to PAX and we won second place at the tournament that they had there. You know, just the people that showed up from our little group, the Studio Rumble. Just whoever was there was like, alright, let's just make a team right now and we'll enter. Second place, dude. We did not expect that.
That's nice.
Pretty rad. Got a little medals and everything.
You still have it?
Yeah, of course. Sleep is the cousin of death. Oh, dude, you didn't have to put Nas after that. I would have gotten that. You know, if you add up all the, like, hours that you sleep each day, week, year, you were asleep a third of your life.
For sure.
You ever thought about that?
Yeah.
Fucked. That's a lot of recharging, man. A third of your entire life just laying there. Come on, man. I don't sleep that much, though. what I'm thinking by not sleeping that much, you're actually like maybe hurting your health to where it evens out and you'll just die quicker. So it's about the same like living. I don't know, feels like a faster lane, I guess. Alright, I think that's smooth enough-ish. TF2 is awesome, never gets boring. Yeah, dude, absolutely. You can play that game for a very long time, unless you're getting spawn camped. Then you're like, okay, I think I'm gonna go to a different server. Holy shit, dude, squaring the circle is supposed to be impossible? What? Oh, he's talking to RD Silver. I think it's RD Silver. We made a square into a circle. I think he's talking about a cube into a sphere. Or just subdued quad and it added polygons and didn't have a hard edge, so it made a circle. Yeah. March 21st? What? I thought I updated that. March 24th. It says 24th on my screen. Enemy? What do you got on yours?
It says the 21st.
21st? Yeah. I can do a screen grab right now. It says 24th on my... Maybe I just have updated to it. Sometimes Twitch actually messes up and it doesn't register your update. Okay, I'm just gonna do twice. Error updating broadcast. Well, that's just wonderful. Error updating broadcast. Yeah, he just won't let me do it. Alright, well, we'll live, I guess. Yeah, won't let me update it. Even though it says 24th, the thing doesn't actually get shut to the server, though. Oh, well.
It's kind of weird.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we can't even do the cogwheel command. I have to explain it. Yeah, Zbrush, man. It's right there in the cogwheel. Hey, what the hell? Oh. Stacy, 1993, what's up? Your mom? What are you talking about, enemy?
He asked me how I got my name.
Wow.
I said my mom.
So very, very technical, sir. Was he not amused on the response?
No, I don't think so.
Do people mess up your name a lot?
Yeah, for sure.
With the A, right?
With the A.
Darren?
Oh no, he's talking about enemy. People always think it's Daryl.
Oh, I thought it was Darren, but you have the A, so it's Darren, right?
It's Darren, yeah. I guess it's like a Canadian way to say it, I don't know. Everyone says Daryl.
I didn't think that when I saw your name.
I mean, when they ask you your name, I'll say Darren, and then they'll say Daryl.
Oh, the sound, like,
It happens all the time.
Actually, I think it happened at DI.
I'm sure it did.
Alright, I think we're gonna work with this. Oh, Silencer, our bot is dead tonight. Sorry about that. The commands won't actually work. I'll build a little bit of a bridge there, even before we do the extrusion stuff. Create a nice little highlight and shadow for us, even if it's a little slight. Barely there, still help out when we combine it with the final one. And then we'll damage the crap out of this too. Should actually do the UVs for this as well at some point. Good shape. ¿Qué tal en tu español? ¿Podrías decir una par de palabras en este idioma? Sí, una o dos. Manny, are you happy the TA set got into the chest? Was that shoved to see a live workshop set get in? That's shoft. Not familiar with that expression, but yeah, man, of course, we're happy every time we see some of our work get into the game. Absolutely. A lot of work goes into each one of them. Any concept art for this? No, we just kind of modeled it out, the concept out of my head, onto low poly that you see right here. A little bit of texture work, a little bit of big work on the cape, and the rest of it's still just unwrapped and being ZBrushed. But yeah, here's the overall design for her. Get the idea where we're going with it. Will you still want to be true? I can't dream. We'll see a brighter day. Alright, subdivision time, and we'll do our mask next. Save our work first. Will do. And I'll just do a quick brush here, see how many more polygons we're gonna actually need. And it looks like Yeah, it looks like there's not enough polygons in some sections here, so let me just do another quick test with another brush. Yeah, maybe just for the top there and for the bottom part, that's gonna have a little bit less less polygons. Might be worth it to do one more subdivision. Yeah. It's still super low anyway, so it's not gonna slow down our ZBrush anyways. Feels a little better. What the F do you think you're doing, man? Sculpting? Do you ever think they will unnerf LC? I don't think she's overpowered. Enemy? Actually, no. He's a huge Legion Commander fan and player, so.
I mean, they nerfed a few of her skills before they put her in captain, so maybe they just dropped her down.
Like what?
That AoE that she does, the arrows, used to do a lot more damage. It's very nice for this. And does very fun to play with.
I think she's in a good spot. I still see her pretty often in games. Much troll, man, that's why.
How can you not play troll? Right
too much too much troll and too much PA on your side.
How can you not play troll? The hero's insane.
I should start playing him. Ah, right, Watson, man, have a good night. Justified law. I don't know if he's trolling or if he's actually mad at us. I can't tell.
It's never good.
Huh?
That's never good.
Or maybe he hates Legion Commander? Or maybe he's being sarcastic and he likes it. I don't know.
Do you come up with concept arts for every set you do, and what inspires you to make it?
Really? Like, a lot of the time... Let me turn down the music on my end. It's just that enemy's a little bit low. Let me see if I can fix this a little bit on my side. Turn up Skype, turn down Firefox. Okay. Feel a lot better now. For the concepts, I don't know, really just think about, like, if I have come up randomly with a good idea for a hero, that maybe something usually sparks it, and then I kind of develop it from there in my head. And a lot of the time I'll throw ideas around with our live workshop team, see what they think about it. And sometimes they have really good ideas, and we bounce ideas off them, or sometimes they come up with really good ideas, and then I just design it off just based off the main idea. Like, our Chaos Knight set was an idea that our PD artist Abyss FX had. So he's like, you should make, you know, we should make a headless horseman set for Chaos Knight or Abaddon. I think at the time we were thinking about doing either one. So we took a look at both heroes, and then from there on, I just kind of concepted it in my head and then just modeled it out. We went from there. Let me show you what we came up with. We haven't submitted this yet because we're probably going to try and do a live workshop chest. But here, let me show you what we got. Where the hell did I put him? Ah, here we go. Did you make a final image of your model? I mean, one that you were following, like a blueprint or something? You mean for concepts? No, man, I just sculpted it straight out. If you think I'll come out of the screen and help you fight in your life with your enemies, then you're wrong, man. I mean, why are you doing this? For what? I have no idea what this guy is talking about.
Nor do I.
I don't know if he's actually hating or I don't. If it's trying to be, I don't know. I really don't know what he's talking about. Live workshop. As somebody who has spent hundreds of dollars on Dota 2 cosmetics, I really look for expansive sets that have custom particles and effects on the hero itself. That's awesome, man. We try to do a lot of that stuff ourselves, and not just on the special effects, but actually trying to make a new version of the hero and really expand on it as much as we can without making it look like a completely different hero. So yeah, it's a careful balance that we have to battle with still. Silencer, confirm sale, huh? You know what's coming out, man. Sanus Coach.
Sanus Coach, yes.
Yeah, see, even the following sound is kind of broken now. I mean, the system we're using is a little bit on beta, so that could be it. That's why maybe the sub thing's not working tonight either. I don't know. Is the helmet, what, the helmet? No, he actually, well, he's the Headless Horseman, all right, so his head is actually on the other side. Let me show you. He's holding the pumpkin on his left hand, and that's the avatar view, and we did facial animations for it and everything, so when the Chaos Knight speaks, the pumpkin is the one speaking. It's also the stun. He throws the pumpkin as the stun. Let me see if I got it on here somewhere. Is it this one? Nope, that's the spawn animation. So I think it's this one. Yeah, it tosses the pumpkin and blows up. Yeah, there's a quick little look at our Chaos Knight set. That's all we'll show you for now.
Eleven on ten would buy.
11 out of 10. Tennis coach. Arcana quality, wow. I don't think it's quite there, but thank you, man, that's really nice. follow the edge work of the polygons a little bit closer, we'll get a nicer bake out for it. Alright, not bad. Save that. Keep doing our mask work before we extrude it. What the hell happened? Okay. I was just saving. Am I bald? I guess you are. Wow. Go to Facebook, man, if you want to see a picture of us while we time you out. Alright, peace out. When will it be finished? This one here? We were in a really crazy deadline for this guy, because it was going to be part of this special thing we were doing. But we're going to start focusing on TI5 sets. So this one will kind of like intertwine in there since it's already so far ahead. But we're going to start looking at a couple of pro sets and some other things that we want to make for to be submitted and done in time for the International 5. The deadline's what, May 26, enemy?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, so we have like about 2 months to do a bunch of those sets. So yeah, we'll get there. You think we'll be able to change the way that particles are done for Source 2 to be released? Yes, we're going to transfer them across to Source 2 when Source 2 drops. And make sure that they all work and everything. I mean, from what we're expecting, I don't think... Like, maybe we'll have to change them by hand or re-import them, but they should work essentially the same, we're thinking. So it shouldn't be a total rework. It's just going to be like a... re-exporting and re-bringing in like all the individual ones that we've made for the unreleased sets, which is a lot of manual work, but it'll be worth it, of course. Our effects are work really well with our direction of for the sets. At least we try to. And we remake them quite a few times to make sure that they work the way we expect them to.
We can't make Troller Zeus because they're not available to us in the workshop yet. But I think that we would like to. I can say that. I would love to make those two heroes.
Yep, absolutely.
Two of my favorites, actually. Most played.
Now.
You play Zeus yourself, don't you?
I played a little Zeus, yeah. Not a crazy amount, but yeah, a little bit. I think you're way better than me at Zeus.
Why is the LD set not in the game yet? Yeah, we answered before, but just hoping that Source 2 makes the LD good to go, I guess, right?
Yeah, I think Valve was working on some tools to make universals for some of the special stuff we made for Lone Druid. So hopefully that gets addressed with Source 2. We're not sure at the moment. We can't really say. We don't know. So we'll have to just wait and see. Hopefully Source 2 brings the Lone Druid. Jato's Dora, are we going to TI5? Yes, me and Enemy will be heading out to TI5. So if you're going there, man, we'll have a beer with you for sure. And we'll try and give you some free shit if you drop by the workshop. You like free shit, right?
Who doesn't? Free is the best price by far.
It's up there. It's up
it's
there.
It's way better than anything in cost.
I'm trying to stay really thin on the edge of the eye here. A little diversity on the framework. And I'll do the masking on the inside a little bit nicer in a second, but right now I'm just worried about the outside. More important.
think as soon as this bake is done, I'm gonna abandon you into the night.
Alright, man. Yeah, it's later in Canada.
Yes, it is. Invoker with custom pro. I don't know if we have an Invoker idea, do you?
No, not at the moment.
That's the one thing that I think we do and start with a solid idea before we make a set, right?
An Invoker?
Well, no, just in general, making sets, we start with the idea and less with the hero most of the time.
Yep. Unless, like, we're working on something that, like, a pro player is really, really wants or something that they reuse a lot, then we'll actually take the time to brainstorm something for that hero in particular.
Yeah. Plans to make Zeus, like we just said, Zeus, we would love to make Zeus, but he's not available. And
yeah.
Drow, I don't know, maybe in the future.
Yeah, I haven't really thought about a set for Drow. I think it's because she had so many sets come out so often back then, and we had so many ideas already in our list that we're trying to get through those ideas first before we start with like kind of go off and brainstorm some ideas for her. Because I mean, she's used quite a bit and she's a cool hero, but we just haven't really thought about sets for her.
I heard so many stories about her base model. Has a lot of armor built into it, so that's probably
like her shoulders or her arms you can't change, right, or something like that.
Yeah, something like is she one of the heroes that has a boot slot as well, maybe like Kunkka?
Oh, and you never quite see the bottom of the leg part. I guess
we almost made a Meepo set. We were very close to making a Meepo set.
Very, very close. Or New Bloom, no less.
He was one of the finalists for what we were going to do for New Bloom.
Last minute, we changed to EA. What's our next set after this one? Well, like I said, we're going to start doing some TI sets, I'm thinking. Some of them we can show, some of them we can't. So one that we'll definitely try and show as much as we can is probably going to be a Windrunner. And we're also going to be working on VG Gaming set. And then I'm not sure if we can show the other ones, but those two for sure.
VG hype, man. I'm all aboard that fan train.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, even more now, right?
Well, I liked Black a lot. I thought it was unfortunate, but I guess it is, that situation is what it is, right?
Yeah. I mean, it's not malicious or anything, you know, but...
Yeah.
If you can't communicate that fast with a game that's extremely fast, I'm sure it kind of hurts a little bit.
Yeah, well, it can't help, right? Even if you're just half a second behind or, you know, quarter of a second behind, that's a big...
That's all it, yeah. Long, that's the difference.
Like having lag in your game, pretty much, right?
Yep.
It's like being on a crappy server. Like, people that have 200 MS can't play pro. It's just ridiculous, so imagine you're trying to think about a different language.
Mm-hmm. He jumped on Thinker, right?
Yeah, he's on
Thinker. You were saying earlier, yeah.
And they're playing quite well. I didn't see the finals of the Star Ladder qualifier, but they were 1-1, I think, for America against Wheel. If anyone in chat knows if that was the finals or not, just let me know. Are you making any TI5 Immortals? No, we're not. Those are going to play
well. Though we have something similar that we were working on with Star Ladder for future content. We did 6 hero bundles that have all new ability effects and new multiple items. But we're probably has to wait for Source 2, we're guessing.
I don't think anyone has done new voice packs for heroes, right? I don't think that's something they'll let you do.
Yeah, I remember Ace, like, commentators wanted to do a whole bunch of stuff. Well, I mean, Pyro. Oh, you mean Hero. Yeah, not Hero.
Announcers, for sure.
Announcers, for sure, yeah.
Custom voice pack for Hero.
Yeah.
Will this set have custom spell icons and skill animations? Maybe the spell icons, right? Possibly.
Spell icons we've done, yeah, for the Phantom Lancer already.
But for this one, LC, who knows, right?
Maybe. We're trying to, I mean, those take a little bit of extra time. Depends on our timing. Since this actually is not going to be in a huge rush, we can probably make them later. But for the other sets that are super, super diverse, like our Lifestealer and our Chaos Knight, we'll definitely be making icons for those, guaranteed.
Skill animations is a little bit of a tougher subject.
Like complete new animations?
Well, just having like a new Q or a new W, for example. It's kind of up in the air right now, right? Until we find out more about the next engine, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sorry, for the butts down tonight, sorry. Omni said that makes him look badass. We actually were helping out another workshopper. See if we can help him put his set into a Starladder chest. So hopefully that stuff gets in. So stay tuned for that, man. It looks pretty badass.
I like that set a lot.
Me too.
It's definitely more badass than the other ones if it gets in.
I like it a lot.
What does it mean when a girl rejects your gift? I have no idea. I mean, 100 different things. They're like actual species.
Wow. Well, it depends what kind of a gift it is to.
Yeah.
It might be your fault.
Yeah, girls are weird. That's the best response to that, Rabbits. I have no idea what girls think.
Like, if it's like a super important date or something, and you didn't buy the right thing, or... I don't know.
I've been with my girlfriend for 8 years and I still have no idea what she's thinking sometimes. It was perfume? I don't know. Did she not like the smell of the perfume? How can you know? You could never know.
Black Panther from Anchorman? It was Black Panther, right?
I haven't seen that movie in such a long time. I didn't even see the second one. Was the second one any good?
I don't think I watched the second one.
It was Wrapped. Oh, she said no to the Wrapped? Like I said, I don't know much about women and what they're thinking, but I don't think that's a good sign. If it was Wrapped.
It was perfume, it was Wrapped. Wait, it was Wrapped? You didn't even smell it before you bought it? Dude.
No, I think he wrapped it and presented it to her, and she said...
She said no right off the bat? With that? Oh... Wait, was this like a gift to a girl that you are not actually dating yet? Because if that's the case, then...
You don't smell good? I don't have to disagree with that.
What?
I don't think... Rabbit says giving perfume is like telling them that they don't smell good.
No. That's if you like give them deodorant or something like that. If you give them perfume, they like perfume, dude.
Yeah, if you bought them like a toothbrush, then that's a bad sign. Yeah. But I think that perfume is okay.
I think perfume's alright, yeah. Yeah, don't buy them like body soap or deodorant. That's like, yeah, that's the line right there.
Yeah, I would agree with you. I would agree with you.
Oh, come on, Zbrush, don't save now. Will we ever make a set for Elder Titan? What do you think, enemy?
I made one a while ago, but I don't know if it has a shot. I think that when Elder Titan had that bug that let you stomp with the spirit moving, he was playable, and then they fixed it, and then he disappeared. But I don't think that was a game-breaking bug. I think they should just put that back in, because it was actually really hard to do.
I don't think I ever saw it.
He would, like, throw the spirit out really far and call it back and then stomp while it was traveling, and the spirit would stop and stomp whenever he finished channeling the spell. And so it's really hard to actually stomp people like that, but the pros
while it's moving. But I mean, it already ascended that far, right? So it's just that it stays out longer, I guess. That's the only thing.
No, so because when he channels the stomp, the spirit channels the stomp, right?
Yeah.
So they would throw their spirit super far and call it back, so that when they channeled the stomp, it would be like over the other team, and they kind of couldn't see it coming. I'm not sure if I'm explaining that.
Like, oh, so that, yeah, no, I get it. So that it stomps as it's moving towards them instead of being there and doing its stun animation and then stomping so that they have no reaction time for it, yeah.
It's actually really difficult to do.
Yeah, because you have to know the exact distance of how far you send it out, right? So.
And it's not like the spirit comes back slow. It comes back pretty fast.
Sure.
And they removed that bug after, I guess, a couple weeks of pros playing it. And then also the pros are bugging out the spirit. So they were recalling the spirit and then using themselves, and it would get stuck there so they could get a timeout. So I'm sure
that's pretty dirty, actually.
Yeah, another reason why they fixed that bug. But I don't see why, if it made him just playable and not broken, they shouldn't consider it as a buff. I like Elder Titan.
Is this Love Workshop?
For a second, man.
We're just giving advice, man. We're not professionals at that.
Yeah, we're not professional advice givers either.
No.
So take it with a grain of salt.
Actually, I think my girlfriend's pretty mad right now that we're streaming this late.
Is she there?
No, I got a text.
She's not in the chat.
No.
She's hiding from chat.
No.
Workshop. That could be a different show.
Let us mess up your relationships 100%. Listen to this shit. Terrible advice.
Are you guys from the US? I'm from Canada, and Manny is pretending to be American.
No. I don't want to be American. I just live here. Yeah, Mexican born and raised, and I have dual citizenship in Canada and Mexico.
YouTube tutorial series that you would recommend for learning ZBrush?
You know, they ask me that quite often, you guys ask me that quite often in the chat, but I really don't know a lot of tutorials. I don't really search out tutorials myself, but I mean, you can just find really nice ones, you know, off YouTube or Vimeo if you search what you're looking for. There's a lot of diversity on tutorials.
Yeah, it's hard to give.
But I can't, yeah, I mean, like, I don't search for them enough to actually, you know, tell you which ones are super amazing today.
I wish I knew a ZBrush website to shout about. I don't know anyone that's for beginners stuff.
For beginners? Well, I mean, if you go off Pixelogic and what is it? Well, it shows you how much I've been to it, but yeah. It's really... Yeah, no, like... I guess ZBrush Central has a link to their... They actually do classes as well. They do like a digital classroom, you know? It's a little, you know, it's... Might be a little pricey, but they have some really nice people doing it. But I think you can find it through Pix, like ZBrush Central, if you go to their forums. It's actually by one of the guys that helps out with actual creation of like Pixelogic and everything.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Hold on. It's the... what's this guy's name? I'll remember it in 2 seconds. The ZBrush Masterclass? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. I can't remember his name, it's gonna bother me.
This mask is taking forever. It's like Ryan, I think, or something.
Ryan Kingsland.
There you go, there you go. Kingsley, yeah.
It's too bad February 14th is already behind us, but next year we could have a love stream on Valentine's Day. That's a good suggestion. That's a really good suggestion. I hope I remember that.
For your sake.
Welcome to the love stream. You hit the deep voice.
Oh, baby.
Have you had any fun or noticeable changes to your pipeline for ZBrush R4? I didn't buy it yet. I don't think you did either, did you?
I haven't checked out the new one yet. I don't know yet.
I fully intend to buy it, though, or get my hands on it.
Yeah.
I can't wait for Love Shop now. Need like a little song.
We got like a new logo and everything.
It's like a heart in the cogwheel.
A hard cogwheel?
Just have the heart spinning one way and the cogwheel spinning the other. Yeah, he's gonna remind us.
Alright.
That'll have to be a drinking stream.
We're gonna have to be really drunk for this stream.
I can manage that.
Done.
Can you post a link?
You artsy? What the hell is that?
It's Ryan King's line site.
No, he's got a different one, man.
That's it for sure, I promise.
Huh.
It's like you take the ZBrush masterclass and stuff. Courses.
They must have changed that.
Yeah, they changed it.
They even changed the design not too long ago, from what I remember. I went to it maybe a month, 2 months ago. And they had like a whole new way of like searching for their masterclasses and the way that the website actually was built.
Actually, one of these classes is given by someone that was in my class at school, Nicola Garin.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, he worked at Game Loft forever, I think. And now, I think he works at a small little indie. Oh, it's a free upgrade, I did not know that.
Yep.
It's scary to switch though, when you're in the middle of something.
Well, yeah, especially for new versions.
So, and in a crunch? I don't know.
Yeah, no. Don't be brave.
No, don't be brave. It's like I asked you if you upgraded your NVIDIA driver and you told me, what did you tell me? Are you new here?
Frontline soldiers, don't come back. Okay, proof.
Like, I guess you have bone skeletal, you have 4R7. I saw in their presentation that it was going to come with Keyshot. Did it actually come with Keyshot?
It's supposed to, yeah.
Yeah, I saw that there was like a bridge, a Keyshot bridge for sale. I thought that was supposed to be free.
It might be for like older versions. Maybe they didn't update that part of the website or something.
I don't know. I was scouting the price. What is your favorite part of your workflow?
Huh. I do get that question every now and then. I like the design section when I actually skipped the concepting, like the 2D concepting part, because I concepted in my head. And since I'm not really presenting this idea to a whole committee or art directors or project managers in a studio, I'm basically that jury for the most part myself. If I'm unsure about it, I'll bring it up, you know, to the rest of the team and, you know, get better ideas or bounce off ideas with the rest of the team and brainstorm on that a little bit. But if I think it's really, really strong, then I run the art direction through that and I just sculpt it out in low polygon. And that whole design section is usually really good. I really enjoy doing that. And also, I guess the point where you get halfway through your texture, where you start seeing what the texture is going to come out and looking like in game, that part's really cool. And then the detailing part of ZBrush, like the very end part where you can see it all coming together and just the micro details, you know, those parts are my favorite. Of course, sitting in game with the materials and everybody else's work on it and the animations and the special effects, and you see it's like, wow, you know, it's it's way more than the just the part that I put into it. You know, that is like the big wow part. But as the parts that I create, those other ones that I mentioned.
Yeah, Keyshot Bridge is basically that transition to the renderer. But they announced that you would get that renderer for free when you purchased 4R7. So I'm curious if they followed through on that, because that would be a big selling point to actually. A Keyshot by itself is like $500, so to get ZBrush and Keyshot together.
Sure. I want to try it out, actually. It's very similar to other like quick renders, like Red Octane or whatever. Maybe not as advanced, but I want to try it out and see how close it is.
Did you see Pixar release Render Man?
I did, but it's for non-commercial work.
Yeah, it's for Maya as well.
So I'm just like, what's the point?
Yeah. It's like a similar viewport kind of thing, right?
Hmm?
It's like a quick render in your viewport.
I'm not sure about the details, actually. I haven't really looked at it.
Watch the little free video.
Yeah, so it's kind of like Keyshot and,
Yeah, just in your viewport, Maya.
Oh, yeah.
He had, like, a box where he had an HDRI and he was rotating it and it was changing the light. It was pretty cool.
Like, was it, like, pixelated and then, like, cleaning up every second,
yeah,
or...?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, so it's like, yeah. It's just, like, the Red Octane and Keyshot, then. But probably refined quite a bit.
I mean, that's the idea, that Keyshot Bridge is basically a GOSI for Keyshot. One button, then transfer. But the fact that it comes with the render engine is the selling point, not like the ease of transferring it, I guess.
Yeah, like...
Really in our workflow, that much.
I've been using...
From ZBrush to a render engine. It's not something you do very often, right?
Switching around, well, at the very end you would import it and do all that stuff like you know you do with Keyshot, but with Red Octane there's plugins that work directly in the viewport, like RenderMan, like you were saying, for Maya and you know whatever. So I actually use Red Octane directly inside of Softimage.
Oh yeah, okay. So it's really similar.
Mm-hmm. Just the material system is really, really difficult in Red Octane. I'm not very good at it.
$250 extra? That's unfortunate.
For Keyshot?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, really?
Because they had that conference that when they showed off all the new stuff. I watched the live stream and they were saying they were going to give it away. It was going to be free.
I heard it was free. That's weird that they changed that. Trying to be extra precise with this mask.
Too bad you can't save it.
I've been saving it.
I meant the mask selection.
Oh, yeah.
Like in mask.
Well, yeah, I mean, I just need to extrude it once and it'll be fine.
If only there was, like, a function that would let you save it. Like a polygroup or something.
Yeah, I mean, the problem is when you want to subdivide and you already drew the mask and you're like screwed. Yeah. That kind of sucks.
Oh, thanks for the link, man. I'll check that out.
There you go, from Bones.
Alright, it's 3 a.m. here, I'm gonna leave you.
Alright, man.
Cheers to the chat, and I'll see you in chat next time.
Alright, man, we'll see you tomorrow. Thanks, enemy, for hanging up. Set our shield so we can be working on the helmet. And extrude out that little frame, just a little bit that we've been really carefully drawing on the mesh. Will there be different styles for the set? We might do a different style for the back item. So we have the cape, the super long cape, and then like a couple of flags. Just in case Valve thinks it's too different to just have the cape. The pen looked like you had giant Pringles as a mustache. A little bit. You can make the mask a polygroup and then clear it, subdivide, isolate mask, and then again, whether or not. Of course, that is not as convenient as it should be. Yeah, it's a little bit of a workflow, but I mean, once I have the mask on there, I basically just expand it and we have our framework, so I mean, that's pretty much all that I really want to do with it. So just drawing it out is already done. I don't need to do a subgroup and all that stuff. The inflate that we're going to do in a second here is all really we need. After that, we can just go through the edge and flatten things out. Oh, when I turn my head away from the cam? Okay. Yeah, like a duck. Can I teach you how to make those models? Dude, that's... I mean, we explain and create the models here live and interact with you guys. So yeah, just keep watching Live Workshop, man. We'll try and help you out. If you have any questions, just ask. Follow along. See, all these edges are pretty okay for the most part. Whoops. Give us something decent. Work off. Then next stream we can do a whole bunch of the damage stuff. Expolish the extruded edges, I presume. You mean like the inside of the edge part? Yeah, yeah, we'll clean that up that way. And then we'll do the damage, the battle worn stuff afterwards. And the micro detail of the like little dots to really make the helmets have that really nice Spartan kind of bronzed finish, aged bronzed kind of thing. The Love Workshop, Merlin, is that what you're talking about? Now, the thing I was messing around with my head a little bit, which we probably won't end up doing, is maybe making the upper brow a little bit thicker. I don't know. We'll test that out real quick. Come on, Tigro, stop saving. No, maybe not that way. Whoops. Do quick little tests here, see what works out. No, I think just straight works for the best. Yeah. We'll let the silhouette do the work. From top view, she already has that angle anyways. That barely shows her eyes. That'll work out. Alright, we're gonna sharpen the mask one more time. Alt control click. And we're gonna invert the mask. Control click away from the mesh. And now we're gonna inflate that part of the mesh by 1.5 or so. Should be enough. So we'll go to deformation and to inflate. Inflate balloon sometimes works really nice. So we'll try both just to see what works. And that's probably a pretty good amount right there. I don't think we need to inflate it. The fact that we'll be doing the H polish right on the edge should fix all that stuff out for us. And this will just be part of the normal map anyways. The low poly, obviously, so you won't have this extra poly selection there. Or poly extrusion. It's just gonna be the texture. So let's see if we go with our H polish tool now. A little bit stronger. Clean this stuff up. Probably don't need to re-subdivide this another time. This will bake out just fine. As long as we get it nice and smooth. Do a quick test here, make sure that most of our edges will work with this. And maybe some of these sections have probably not the best angle. So the way to fix those angles is to smooth out the edge and then start re-pushing in a different angle with your edge polish. Mitsuto, yeah man, we're gonna do battle damage for sure. I'm just trying to figure out if this is the right way about doing the edge work. It's getting a little too sharp. I'm not sure, maybe it needs to be a little bit smaller. But if we go smaller than this, it probably won't show up very well in the texture bake. And will kind of be blurry or pixelated. So I'm just trying this out quickly, see if does something. That will bake out correctly. I want to try something else real quick. Try that inflate. Too far. Where's our flip? Inflate balloon. Try 0.8. Not quite what we wanted. Oh god, it's gonna go crazy right now, yeah. Wow, even 0.8 is really, really strong. Okay. Try 0.4. I want a softer edge for it, so when we flatten it, it's not really changing that harshly across. I don't want it to be super flat. So let's try this real quick. Bit of a smoother transition right off the bat. So it'll lessen the amount of work we have to work with the H-polish tool, which is always a good thing. And I think this part we need to flatten up a little bit. I think that is way better than what we had before. So if that continues all the way through the edges, a little bit smoother, it'll give us a way better cut. More of that angle that will show up better in low resolution textures. I'm gonna turn this up a little higher so we can do less brush strokes and do some of this finessing a hell of a lot quicker. So we just want it to be a little bit there, you know? This is actually working pretty good. I think I'm gonna keep this. Quick couple of tests will allow you to select the right inflation or extrusion of your edge work. This one's a little bit less eye-catching, which is good. We just want a little bit of a frame, that's all. And then doing the damage over top all of this stuff is going to be super, super easy. But we have really nice clean edges. Love the work. I have 300 LC games. Can't wait to see the model finished. Awesome. Maldizio? Did I say your name right? I hope so. I need to play more LC, man. I like the hero, but I haven't used it enough to be really good. Virus Link Kappa. Hey, Captain, thank you for the follow. Manny, what's the material you have set for the model? Something like one of the waxes? No, this is, what is it, QW under dash pewter. It's my go-to sculpting material. The rim looks amazing. Yeah, it's getting there. It's really easy, really. Once you get the hang of it, you can do this for anything. Just learn the angles a lot better, whether you do inflate or whatever, and then use the H polish tool appropriately. It's really easy to mess up, you know, the angles and get it to render really clean. Like if you give them more room so that there were more angle instead of like straight up extrusion, you give those pixels more space in your normal map to actually show the light. In the engine, the rendering engine. Another thing that I wanted to play around with was flattening the front a little bit, so we get a little bit of a sharpness to the very front. So this is super, super smooth right now. I don't quite want it that smooth, so I might have to go lower in subdivisions and do a few tests of flattening out the front a little bit like this. I might need that and mask that out again, but this isn't looking too bad. See if I can pull it off the first time without doing any tests. I don't know. Not too bad. I'm gonna have to push in a little bit with a standard brush. Yeah, a little bit sharper. A little more aggressive with that flat, this is gonna be. Be really careful with the way that it goes towards the nose. Really easy to mess this up. Also doing the brush strokes in a vertical way, trying to get a little bit of a man-made metal finish to it. Not as the last metal stuff that we've done on the streams before, which has been a lot more like raw, just hitting the volumes into place by a blacksmith. But this a little more refined, but you still see a little bit of the vertical flatness to some sections, and that'll make it look a little bit more metallic, a little bit more man-made. A little more imperfect, maybe. And I want to sharpen some of these sections out at the same time here. Emphasize a little bit of the cheekbone, a little bit of this difference here, this little almost like metal wrinkle. And then back to some vertical stuff here. Flatten this guy's out. Starting to get a little bit of that look. It might be a little bit hard to see on the stream, but it's looking okay. I'll change the specular a tiny bit when we do a normal map. So it'll help even in game. This little bit that we're doing. Emphasize some of these cuts a tiny bit more. Make the front one a lot larger, so it kind of mimics a little bit of a facial expression, a little bit of more meanness to the helmet. Want to look badass, right? That's not bad. Let's save it as a different version in case we want to go back for whatever reason. We'll do the same for the back. Keep it more, a little bit of this, roundness gradient, a little bit more, faceted. More flatter sections. A little bit. And we should also go back and actually start doing a little bit more of that framework that we started. Harsher on it, work faster. I'm thinning it out at the same time. If you go stronger with it, more brush strokes, you're gonna push those polys out of the way. And it's doing both things, two things at the same time. Thinner and smoother. Two things I want to do. And up here we're gonna a little bit thicker. The bottom part. Thinner up top. Probably done on time. 2:25. Alright, it's not too late. Doing pretty okay. We'll have this all set up so that we can do the all the damage stuff tomorrow. Oops. Hey, what's up, Marwick? A little sharp here, so I'm gonna smooth it out a tiny bit. Run a few more layers of edge polish on it. Alright. What up, Duty Bomber Deluxe? Alright. Doing alright, dude. Trying to finish up this smooth edge work. A little bit of the metal feel to the main section before we do the damage pass on it, which will probably have to be tomorrow. And then this bottom brim, I don't want it to be as thick as the eye section, so it's gonna be a little bit smoother. Not as sharp. And even a little bit thinner, but still have this edge pointing upwards so it catches a very nice little highlight from the normal mat from any lights that are hitting it from above. Nice little touch. Whoops, we'll do those strokes. Okay, that'll work. Let's rotate this way now and do these guys real quick. Are also pretty small. We don't want these guys to really attract too much of the lighting. If anything, they'll do a little bit of a shadow there for the ambient occlusion, but that's it. The vertical line, so not a big deal. And the bottom, we probably want to flatten this guy out a bit more, so we're gonna have to smooth it first and then run our brush through it. And our brush is gonna be a little bit closer to the middle, so it starts reconfiguring the angle, so it's a little flatter. So see, I'm remaking that angle instead of just following what it started off with. It takes a little bit more work and a little more strenuous on your hand, but try and move your fingers around and not really do it for too long. I usually end up hurting my hand pretty bad. That will flatten out how smooth this stuff is as well. Getting a little bit round because of the inflate, but we'll just flatten it out. Oops. Pixels. Pixels again. Really careful sometimes. There we go. Something gets too round, we'll fix it with the move tool at the very end. No biggie. And the front, we're probably gonna flatten out a little bit more. A little bit more battered, more used. A little thicker. Build for more resistance. Do the job. A little bit bent here. Do the trick. Maybe a little bit smooth there. Another angle. Go. It's Theo. Have a good night, man. Check you out later. Oh, you were saying goodbye to Silencer. Alright, see you later, Silencer. Mitsuo's still sticking around. Alright. Alright. Let's be really careful with this part. It's a very important part of the mask. Helmet. You always wanted to make more of a feminine Legion Commander skin. No one wants to make something like that. Well, I mean, we got... for our design, we kind of get rid of the super huge shoulder armor stuff that a lot of the sets have and the default one have. So, this is more Spartanish, where it's just, like, more of a foot soldier, right? More of a footer soldier. Like, they're all almost equals, right, in the Spartan army, so... we got rid of a lot of that crazy, not fantasy, but more of the over-the-top armor. Even though she still is really heavily armored, it's just not like crazy over the top kind of like kingly, you know, just more like one of the warriors, like they're all, you know, in the same kind of category. So yeah, that's felt more Spartanish for her. Still dressed up quite a bit like a Legion Commander is supposed to be. Coming along. How about a bull nose ring? I mean, she already has like the one ring on the one nostril, right? But a full nose ring, I don't think it's very Greek or Spartanish, which is the kind of art direction we're going in. So it would be kind of badass for her, but I don't think it fits the art style we went with. Alright, this top part's a little bit tricky because it gets infused a little bit heavier into the back. Around the skull, back of the skull. So we're gonna have to use some different tools to kind of engrave that a little bit deeper. But we'll just flatten that first. First pass over here. Make sure we know where our edge is gonna be. Kind of messed up that a little bit. Do it again. There we go. Okay. Tricky part because the low polygon actually goes into a little bit of a connection there, so okay for now. I have to build that out with a different brush, yeah. Throw more clay at it. Build it a little bit and then reshape it. Get a better angle here. Doing this out, a little bit more clay here and there. Slowly fix it up, and then we can polish it a lot easier. And then try to do a little bit of the same treatment to the top. A little more of that man-made feel to the roundness, like perfectly round. A lot of these helmets have to be done really quick for a large army, so they're not going to be perfectly round. More functional and pretty. More battle-worn and new. What we're gonna go with. Alright. The hell was that? Can we save it now, please? Okay. Hey, what's up, Razor? Joining late, man. We're almost there. Rarious, yes, we're gonna be damaging the helmet quite a bit, but we're gonna do that next stream. Right now, we're just kind of like doing the first pass on the overall feel of the helmet, the build for it, and then we'll run it through a whole bunch of battles. We'll scar it up from the middle to the point that it's more of aged and has little holes and decrepitness to it, to the metal. It's very Spartan oriented, the set. We're going with that kind of Spartan Greek armor style for her set. Trojan, yeah, good. Another. Very Trojan, kind of Irish. Pointy, a little pointy towards the top, even way pointier than the Spartans. We kind of emphasize that even more. You want to bring this out even more. Whoops, way too strong. That is way nicer. Gonna save that. Very cool. Like that. Hey, what's up, Cyber? You're welcome, Witch. No problem, dude. think it looks like a female silencer. Yeah, a little bit right now because of the length of it, but once you can see all the textures and the colors, it should really pull away from that silencer look you're talking about. Yeah, this song is really catchy. Oh, it's a remix, I don't even know what song it is. Whoops. A little bit of a bend into it, a little bit of a difference. Why not? Why not? I can't close my eyes, 'cause there's a feeling somewhere inside. Whoops. And again, for the top side, just a little bit softer on the rim. Oops. Try that again. Oh, please don't crash, Zbrush. Xbox homies, what's up, dude? The hell just happened here? Whoa! How far it went on the history? I've never seen Zbrush do that before. Alright, please put us back to where we were. You're still thinking? Oh, what's up, Godoza? Just got home. Oh, right on, man. Where you from? Alright, Zbrush is freaking the hell out right now. Might lose a little bit of work here. Well, let's try to read our history. Come on back to us, Zbrush. No, still thinking? Oh man. Yep, it's freaking the hell out. Wow, the hell. Well, show you guys our in-game, low polygon stuff. We start it. Maybe Zbrush will come back to us? No, I think it's pretty fried. Freaking out, man. Killed it. Alright, let's try and reload that tool, I guess. No, it's dead. He's dead, Jim. I think we just have to kill it all together. And reload it. What the hell, Kotaku? No, man. Just Zbrush, thanks. Bones, yeah, I save quite often actually, man. I do. That's why we didn't lose a lot of work there. We lost like maybe just the last flattening part. Yeah, thanks, Zbrush. I got it, man, I got it. Yeah, just the very top part's what we missed. Missed out on. It's okay. We should do that real quick. Whoops. Make sure our symmetry is on. That's the top view, thank you. And I think we did a little bit of refinement here that we might have missed out on, I don't know. A little bit. Okay, okay. I don't know, man. I've heard the 64-bit's a little bit crashy. So, yeah, let's not switch just yet to the newer Zbrush. So the detail pass is actually going to be really, really interesting. We're going to do battle scars and aging on the metal, whatever material the helmet is. We'll also start doing a little bit of metal. Whoa, that's too strong. Some metal wrinkles. Oh, my undo is a little bit broken. There you go. Vertical strokes look really nice. Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, I think they'll show up a little bit on the normal map and the specular. And I give it that really bash, you know, man build metal look. So that's what we're aiming for. Hopefully it works out. I'm just gonna start sketching a little bit of damage, a little bit of the wear. And then as we zoom out and see the model from a distance, we'll be able to really emphasize the ones we really wanna help contribute to the overall look. And maybe add a little bit of a facial expression out of the damage on the helmet itself. Live Workshop and you in general on 3D art sites like Polycount and Ast Art Station. Hey, Witch, thanks for that follow. You browse them from time to time, but you never seen us guys work on them. No, we're like our own like live stream website where we have our broadcast archive. If you go to liveworkshop.com, you can see a whole bunch of our past broadcasts. We have like another 100 or so videos we still need to put up. And yeah, we're more of the live kind of showing you how we do this, explaining those things, and helping you guys out and answering questions. Hello, Bonaya. Welcome back, man. Oh, Rulok, you haven't had any crashes at all with 64-bit? That's really cool, man. Yeah, we'll switch to it. We're just super busy right now. I don't want to spend the time to settle that new stuff up and hope that it's a good fit on my PC. So we'll get to it, man. We'll upgrade and definitely check it out. Big fan of Zbrush. We're working on a Legion Commander set for Dota 2, man. We're doing the first pass on the helmet. We smoothed it out earlier tonight, and then we did the framework for it. All these guys that are a little bit extruded out, and a few minutes ago we've just been kind of polishing it up and getting the frames to be nice and flat so that they create a really nice normal map for us. And next up is a little bit of the initial stage of aging it and denting some damage into it. It's gonna be pretty battle worn. So right now I'm just doing the stuff that is gonna be a little bit mirrored, a little more of the universal kind of dents and build for it. And then we'll see which parts we need to just do uniquely. And I guess we should do the UVs first. I haven't done the UVs for this helmet, so. Maybe do that first next stream, and then jump onto the crazy damage detail and all that. Super fun stuff to watch. But yeah, just gonna kind of dig into some of these. This is a nicer cut when we do our ambient occlusion pass. And maybe this one's not as perfect. Maybe it sticks out a little bit. Maybe a little bit into a crack or something. gonna make a little bit of a metal wrinkle here on this bent. Metal wrinkles. Not bad, not bad. What do you think we're going to finish with the set? It really depends how much we have to just start jumping onto other projects for TI5. So I'm not sure. We'll try and keep working on this one every now and then. If we had to finish it like right away, we probably finish this for like next week. But we are going to be starting a whole bunch of other projects at the same time. Show me the shield! Actually, let me I can show you the ZBrush, or I can show you a quick little screenshot. Go to my push account over here. Do that off screen. They're loading. So I'll show you, we did the gauntlet. And then a little bit of the evolution of the shield. So there's the gauntlet that we did day before. Two days ago, I think. I don't know. And there's the initial part or pass on the shield when we did our stencils. Then a little bit more for refinement, like hand kind of sculpting, I guess, these little dudes. And a little bit more in the middle there with another stencil. And then the finish sculpt, a little bit more stylized, a little bit more broad so that we get nice bakeouts for a really small texture for Dota. And then when we do the textures, we'll figure out how many parts of it we actually need to bring out and simplify even at that stage, so that it's not a complete mess as such a small texture. But it's looking pretty alright. Actually, I think, and yeah, Enemy made a quick bake here. Or not quick, but he worked pretty hard on making this the bake from our ZBrush onto our ambient occlusion. So this actually scaled down to a 256 by 256 texture in-game. And a lot of the details actually coming through, so when we do our color pass on that, we can clean it up a little bit and make sure that the highlights read and the background is not as busy, so we still get the contrast, but it's nice and clean. But yeah, it came out pretty good. So see, when you zoom out, you see all the sections still pretty nice. Pretty good for 256 texture. Pretty happy with that. But yeah, we'll be making more of these materials and light passes onto that texture as well. This was just like kind of like the shadow pass. Scale down at that as well. Yeah, that's a shield. I'll show you it in here too if you want. Whoops. Where are we? There we go. Whoops. All right, 3 in the morning, you guys. I think we're gonna stop right here. We have a, we did a really some nice work on the helmet. A really nice start. First couple of passes for it. We next stream tomorrow. We'll continue the stream. We will move on to, well, I guess continue doing that little refinement on the edge work, a little bit of the build, make it feel like those pieces are actually built into it. Some of them are got broken along the edge. It'll help us define from a distance, add some extra little shadows, and see it more as separate shapes. And then after that, we'll do the damage pass on it, which is going to be the most fun part to do, and to watch, I suppose. And then we'll do the ring on the shoulder, and move on to, I guess the weapon is the last part we need to do for her. Is that right? Oh, we still have to do the loincloth, so a little bit of cloth left to do, and the emblem on her crotch plate. So a little more design work there as well. I haven't really decided what to put on her her pelvis belt that you can see right here. And then some cloth there. There's our cape that we started texturing a little bit. Some nice damage on it as well, some tear, aging. And then, yeah, then we'll do the spear afterwards, but yeah, it's moving along, guys. Moving along. All right. Thank you so much for the follows, guys, the subs, appreciate your support. Company, your ideas. Make sure you guys drop by our Facebook page. You can check all our channels. If you go down to liveworkshop.com, at the very top right, you can see all our channels, Twitter, Facebook, Twitch, which we're in right now, our Steam workshop page. You can see all the stuff that we submitted. broadcast archive where you can see a whole bunch of stuff that we haven't submitted that we're still working on or have finished but are waiting to do something special with it. And yeah, make sure you throw us a follow on here so you guys can see us tomorrow. All right, guys, thank you so much. Have a good night. We'll see you next stream. Hopefully, it'll be a little earlier tomorrow. We started way too late tonight, but got a lot done. All right, guys, peace out.